Good morning. It is a very great pleasure to welcome you, first of all to the Society of Antiquaries, and then more specifically to today's conference on secret spaces. Let me find my glasses first of all. Before I go any further with that, Leslie has made what I think is the entirely appropriate suggestion that I say a few words about Peter Kitson, who died a fortnight ago. Peter was known to so many people. In fact, I would hazard a guess, it's possible, that he was known to everyone in this room, whether as a teacher, whether as a scholar through his published work, or as a friend. And there will, of course, be those who knew him in all three capacities. He was an extraordinary teacher. Those of us who had the good fortune to be taught by him. He did his PhD in 19, finished his PhD in 56, and shortly afterwards appointed as a member of staff at the Court of, and he remained there teaching and looking after the Conway and various things for the next 30 years. As I said, he was an extraordinary teacher, and I have one recollection to pass on to you, which will give you an idea of his approach to things. The seminar involved was due to run from 10 to 12, and it was a student who was reading a paper. Well, Peter encouraged so much debate and discussion on the paper that by 12:30 we had nowhere near got to the end. And he said, let's go to the pub, and you may know which pub that is. Out of Portman Square, turn right, turn into Gloucester Place, up to George Street, and there it is, his favourite pub. Well, we had a very enjoyable lunch, he came back to his room, and eventually he deemed that the seminar was complete. That seminar lasted 5 hours, I'm not including lunch. So that gives you an idea of the quality and character of his teaching. His contribution to architecture, many of his contributions to architectural history, are legendary. And again, let me just mention a couple. The one that stands most clearly in my mind is the dimensions of the Pantheon. The dome, the interior diameter of the dome of the Pantheon, is 147 Roman feet. Well, what sort of nonsensical number is that, scholars said. They must have intended it to be 150. You know, that's a decent number. But 147 is in the best kind of Roman foot, 29.4, 28, 29.5 centimeters. And in the period of Hadrian, that was one of the best periods when it was applied. So it doesn't work. They suggested that they had run into those panels in the dome to get to 150 feet. But again, there's a problem because the external, by the way, the interior height of the building is also 147 Roman feet. The drum on the exterior is 105 Roman feet. So again, it's an odd number. Anyway, it's puzzlement, puzzlement until Peter said, hang on, there's only one other dimension that you need in order to build this building, and that's the thickness of the walls. And they are 21 Roman feet thick. Well, 105 Roman feet is 5 units of 21. 147 is 7 units. And of course, 5 to 7 is that standard popular side to diagonal ratio in round numbers. So I think he got it, although there's still some disagreement about it. You'd not be surprised to hear. And then right at the other end of the character of evidence, he worked on and did a lot of work on the fairs and markets of the second half of the 12th century in northern France. And he showed that there was a correlation between the growth of these fairs and the adoption of the Gothic style. So, I mean, you couldn't have two more different forms of evidence than the metrological or proportional and the social one of markets and fairs. Well, I think that all I can say after that is he meant so much to so many people, he will be sorely missed. Let me now turn again to the business of today, to secret spaces. And the first thing to do is to thank and to say all power to Eduardo Cabrera Santa Maria, Alexandra Gajewski, Michael Carter, and Leslie Milner. I know what I know about secret spaces from Leslie Milner's marvelous thesis on the subject. And one of the things that I found fascinating was how they express the function of the building. All buildings have a function, they wouldn't be made for otherwise, but I think these secret spaces are unique in having two conflicting ways of expressing themselves. On the one hand, you have the obvious one, the common one, which is where you actually hide the function among all the other church buildings. But what about those few, such as Nantes-en-Vallée, that's right, it's in Charonne, and there are one or two examples in England as well, where the purpose of the building is expressed in its architectural character. The one at Nantes is actually a miniature castle tower. So, the conflict. Take your pick, hide the function, or show it. Well, the sessions are going to be chaired by Dr. Amanda Dotset from the Meadows Museum in Dallas and Dr. Jana Kajdoshova from the Sam Fogg Gallery in London. And our warm thanks to them. So let the day commence.